Dear children, let us start our day with a beautiful thought. Intelligence plus character, that is the core of true education, which means the function of education is to teach one to think intensively and to think critically. It gives us power of concentration and worthy objectives upon which to concentrate. So today we will start with our lesson number 10, that is Ancient India Cultural. So languages and literature, let us see. There was a non-stop without break literatures are going on from ancient India. And these literatures were produced in Sanskrit and Ardhamagadhi. What is Ardhamagadhi? Ardhamagadhi means Indo-Aryan language. Then Pali language and Tamil language. Understood? This literature includes many things, such as poetry, drama, fiction, creative imagination, non-fiction, songs, journalism, grammar, epics. Epics means long stories like Ramayana and Mahabharata. Plays. Plays means what? Dramas, stories, etc. Let us see Sangham literature. You can see in the picture various literature books. Understood? So let us start with Sangham literature. This is a Tamil one. Okay, Sangham literature is a Tamil literature. And in this Sangham literature, we learn about the political and social life in South India during the period. Understood? Sangham means what? Many learned people, many intelligent people, many educated people wrote something together. Therefore, it formed a Sangham literature. Understood? Let us move on to the religious literature. Religious literature means what? Dharmic. Dharmic Sahitya, which tells us about our rituals, our tradition, our religion, etc. And among them, in religious literature, we have Agama Grantha, Tipitaka, and Bhagavad Gita. So what we are going to learn exactly in religious literature? Agama Grantha, Tipitaka, and Bhagavad Gita. Jain Agama Granthas are written in Prakrit language of Ardhamagadhi. Shaurya Seni and Maharashtri. Here Prakrit language means what? Natural language of Ardhamagadhi. Shaurya Seni, Ardhamagadhi means what? Indo-Aryan language. And a dramatic Prakrit thought. In dramas, this Ardhamagadhi language was used. And in our modern days, this Ardhamagadhi have been spoken in Uttar Pradesh, that is in northern part of India, and basically it is a Jain literature. Understood the meaning of Jain Agama Grantha, which was written in the Prakrit language of Ardhamagadhi. Shaurya Seni means dramatic tone, and Maharashtra means Marathi. Let us see the picture of Prakrit language. Understood? Children, on page number 48, you can see many, many writers who wrote these literatures. Names of them are given. Understood? Among them, now we are going to talk about Tipitaka. Understood? Later on in next video, I will tell you about Bhagavad Gita. Understood? Now let us talk about Tipitaka. What is Tipitaka? Tipitaka means three baskets. Three parts. The word pitika means a basket or collection of books. Here it means Tipitaka is written in Pali and it means the text is written in three categories. Sutta Pitaka, Vinaya Pitaka and Abhidhamma Pitaka, which tells us about the teachings of Gautam Buddha. Understood? So Sutta Pitaka, it includes the text of Gautam Buddha's teachings or sermons. Sermons means what? Upadesh, lectures of Gautam Buddha, which is also known as Suktas. Now what is Vinaya Pitaka? Vinaya Pitaka means to think. The word Vinaya here means rules, how to behave, how to think, and these behavior or these rules in Vinaya Pitaka are given by bhikkhus and bhikkhunis. Bhikkhu is male and bhikkhunis is a female word used for the persons who devote their life for Gautam Buddha. In the Buddha Sangha, how to behave in our day-to-day life is given in this Vinaya Pitaka. Now the third one is Abhidhamma Pitaka. Abhidhamma Pitaka, in this, Buddhist teachings have been explained. A text titled Attakatha means Arthakatha, which has meaning Arthakatha, which explains the Tipitakas. Learned women also composed gathas about their own experiences in their own life, from their own life. They have been compiled in Theri Gatha. They are in also Pali language. So, today we have learnt about a Sangham literature which was written in Tamil. And also religious literature which tells us about the rituals, the religion, Dharmic Sahitya. And in religious literature, today we have learnt about Agama Grantha, Tipitaka. And in our next video, we will learn about Bhagavad Gita. In Agama Grantha, which was written in Prakrit language, was Ardhamagadhi, Shaurya Seni, that is dramatic, and Maharashtri. And the Agama Granthas are a collection of teachings of Vardhaman Mahavira. I have already told you, Jain Agama Granthas. And so many literature, biographies and Mahapuranas and stories were written in this Jain Agama Grantha. The name of such writers or learned men are mentioned on page number 48. You will have a look or and learn, you can learn those names given on page number 48. Now, we'll continue with Bhagavad Gita in our next video. Till then, see you children. Bye-bye children.